Hi there, I'm here to show you how to create a two-column layout using floats in CSS. I'm going to be using CodePen. If you haven't used it before, it's an HTML, CSS, and JavaScript editor that you can use on the web. It allows you to kind of create little experiments so that you can see how your HTML, CSS, and JavaScript work together in real time. In my pen, I have my HTML over here. I have a div called content container. I have another div inside of that called sidebar and content. And then I have a div with the class of clear at the bottom and then a closing for my content container. Over here is my CSS. So I want to show you first by commenting out some of this code what this will look like without much CSS. So I'm going to remove the margin zero auto, which centers the whole layout. I'm going to remove the width on the content container. And I'm also going to remove the floats, just so you can see how this HTML acts on its own. So by default, my sidebar and content are just going to be stacked. And I have some widths on there, so that changes that as well. So if you take off your width too, it'll all take the full width of your screen. So first we'll add our widths to our columns. And then to get them to stack, we'll turn on float left for both of them. And then before I turn on that float for the content, you can see how floating my sidebar to the left takes it out of the flow of the content. And then any other content that's still in the flow flows around it. All right, so now they're both side by side. One of the issues with this right now is that if we take our browser and make it a little smaller, they stack right back up again. So to fix that, we have the content container around it. I'll add a width to it, and that automatically keeps it from stacking again. To center it, we'll do margin zero auto. The zero stands for the top and bottom margin, so we could change that if you wanted to. Do 100. For this, we'll just keep it to zero. The auto is what keeps it automatically centered from each side there. So the last thing I want to talk about is the clear. So we have this gray background from the content container. And without this clear div, it wouldn't show up. When you take all the elements in a div and float them, they all come out of the flow of the document. So then that content container div then thinks it has no content, so it's 0 pixels high. What adding this clear div does is makes another element, and I'm gonna turn on this background and the height of it so you can kind of see what it's doing. So it's going to go below those two things, clear, and then anything else we add after this just goes right below it instead of wrapping around these two things. If I take off the clear, you'll see that it goes straight behind those two elements. So you can kind of see what it's doing. So if you want a background behind your layout that's just in that one area, not just your whole body, that's how you would do that. One other thing I want to talk about is floating to the right instead. So say we wanted to have our sidebar floated to the right. So we'll take this and float it right. And then you can, instead of having your margin on the right, you'll put it to the left. And it's easy as that to swap it without even changing your HTML. I hope that helps you create your two-column layout in CSS. And if you have any questions, you can always email your instructor.